Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to download and install InDesign. And to do this, you'll need to have a subscription to it, either through the individual program with Adobe or through the full Creative Cloud suite. Now, if you don't have a subscription and you want to know how to get it really cheap or sometimes free for a little while, you can go to the video right up here at the top of your screen. All right, let's get started. Now, I do want to mention before we get too far, your computer needs to be able to meet the minimum tech specs for InDesign. You'll need at least 8 gigabytes of RAM, but 16 is better, of course, 16 or more. And then here are the rest of the specs, but that is the one that really trips people up. They don't understand why InDesign is slowing down and not moving as fast, and that RAM is usually the reason for that. First, we'll need to go to the Adobe website, adobe.com. Next, we'll come up here to Creativity and Design and view all products. And here you can start a free trial, or you can go ahead and buy it if you don't already have it. If you are a subscriber, go ahead and sign in now. Then you'll get to a page like this page. And I've got Creative Cloud All Apps, so I'm going to go ahead and click Access Your Apps and Services. I'm going to scroll down here to InDesign and we'll choose Install. It'll ask us if we want to open the Creative Cloud desktop app. You might not have this. If you don't, you'll need to install it. So I'll open the Creative Cloud desktop app. We'll have to sign in again. So we can see right here that InDesign is installing. And of course, this will take some time. InDesign should automatically launch itself once it's done installing. But if you can't find it or you're not seeing that, go to your Finder. And then on any Finder window, you can just hit Shift Command A to get to your applications, and then you should be able to see it in your list. And that's it. You should now have InDesign installed on your computer and ready to use. Sometimes Adobe will want you to activate it with your Adobe ID and things like that, but you can just enter your username and password and you should be ready to go. In the next video, I'll show you how to set up your workspace. So getting all the little windows and panels where you need them for the best efficiency. And I also plan to publish a full InDesign course, and if that is published and ready to go, you'll be able to see it on your screen right up here. All right, I hope you liked this video. If you did and you want to see more videos like this, you can just hit the little subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you!